Hi, my name is Dr. Schweinsgruber from audioreviews.org. Typically, I'm reviewing portable audio gear, headphones, earphones, but today we are having a look at this GE side-by-side fridge and freezer. Now the problem with this GE fridge and freezer is that the water line here keeps on freezing. The fridge is about 15 years old, and the problem occurred maybe once every half year. So it defrosted the fridge, and it was all good. But not anymore. Now it freezes every few hours, and the issue has become really annoying. There are quite a few fixes offered on the internet, and I will show you that these fixes are entirely intermittent and therefore useless. They only tackle the effects of it, the freezing, but not the cause of it. And whenever you apply that fix, the problem will reappear. So this is the issue on this GE fridge. You see that the water dispenser, ice dispenser, and when you put this underneath here to dispense some water, it is frozen
Look
sometimes.
inside
Here we see the water tube, and this water tube freezes up about 3 to 4 inches above the nozzle. What is the indication that something is wrong with electronics? Because that's what the repairman can address. First of all, there is no ice buildup, so defrost mechanism appears to work. Thermosensor appear to work. You hear the evaporator fan sounds very healthy, and the airflow is good between the fridge and freezer. You may get frost buildup, even if your electronics work fine. When you have a gasket that's not sealing, when your ice dispenser flapper doesn't seal, or when you have airflow problems between fridge and freezer. But that would also affect the freezer, the fridge. It means that the fridge wouldn't work that well either. But the fridge works fine, the freezer works fine, and the water line freezes. So what's the
You also get
problem?
warm air in the freezer, and therefore frost buildup when your flapper door, your ice flapper, ice dispenser door does not seal. But this one still seals, wasn't used very much in its lifetime. One of the reasons why you get moisture in your fridge could be the rubber gaskets are worn.
So if the gaskets don't seal anymore, you just rub them in with petroleum jelly such as Vaseline. So one of the intermittent fixes is just putting a bottle of hot water in the dispenser area and sealing it with a tea cozy. And it takes possibly 2 tries with hot water and about 3 hours in my case to clear the water line, but then it freezes again after another 3 hours. So it's not a permanent fix. So one of the fixes that was offered here was the so-called water line buddy or ice syringe. What it is a syringe with a tube, and you feed that tube up the nozzle. Well, it gets stuck after 3 to 4 inches because that's where the plug is. Then you connect the included syringe to the tube and you squirt hot water in there, and after 3 or 4 times it miraculously cleans out the water line, which of course makes sense because hot water freezes ice, thaws ice rather. But it's not a permanent fix when you do this every 3 to 4 hours. The water line freezes
one
again.
One of the fixes suggested was putting a 8 to 9 inch weed whacker cord at a strength of 0.095 inches into that water line and wiggle it when it freezes. The problem is once it's frozen, it doesn't wiggle anymore. It's just frozen.
Squirting hot water into the nozzle, into the frozen water line, or adding a weed whacker cord do not save you the repairman. Absolutely not, because they don't tackle the cause. They only tackle the effect. So we now know that it's not the electronics that are faulty. So I did isolate the problem. And the first thing I did is, after I thawed the water line with a hot water bottle and the tea cozy, I just stuffed a towel in there and closed the door. Now what this does is, first of all, it seals the ice flapper for the case, the ice dispenser flapper for the case it was faulty, and it also kind of insulates the inside of the door, kind of. But it worked. It didn't freeze. So the water line freezes when you have got moisture buildup in this area and there's not enough insulation inside. So what I've done here, I put the insulation on the outside. To further eliminate the problem, I stuffed just a drying towel into the ice dispenser flapper, because if the ice dispenser flapper doesn't seal properly, now it does. And my final isolation effort was just removing the towel from the ice dispenser area and entirely rely on the pot holder insulation. And it worked. Problem solved. The freezing area is around here, and I used 5 strips of double-sided tape to attach it to. And the problem with the double-sided tape is that many of these tapes don't work at minus 20 degrees. So it's about minus 20 degrees here inside this freezer, and you have to get the right double-sided tape. Okay, I was lucky that I had the right tape in my drawer. It's the only double-sided tape I have. And it works just fine at minus 20 degrees. So the glue molecules don't give in. So it's a simple Scotch tape, costs like $3 in any store. So in my case, you didn't need a repairman. You didn't need to replace any thermostat or fan or temperature sensor. All you needed is insulation. Obviously, there's an insulation problem inside the door, and you just add the insulation to the outside, and it works just fine. No repairman needed, no weed whacker cord needed, no water line body needed, and no ice surrender needed. It's just simple physics. So this was the little fridge episode of audioreviews.org. If you liked what you saw, please subscribe to our YouTube channel, push that bell up there for notifications, and push that PayPal button to support our work here at audioreviews.org. And I hope I could solve the problem for you today. That long-standing 15-year-old problem. As always, I am your Dr. Schweinsgruber from Calgary. Auf Wiedersehen.